expression of inner love and devotion they have in their heart. Jesus Christ reminds us that in the beginning, the Creator made us male and female, and said, "For this cause a man shall leave his father and his mother, and shall cleave to his wife, and the two shall become one flesh." God loves us and created us to love others. Our lives find completion only as we love and find love in return. Together we can become what we could never be separately. Marriage is of God. Benton Williams and Laura Reisner come today during Desiring to be United in this Sacred Relationship. Benton Williams, is it now your intent to establish your home with Laura Reisner as her husband, to receive her as your wife, to make her a home where she will be loved and cared for as long as God grants her life? If so, answer, I do.
I do.
Laura Reisner, is it now your intent to establish your own home with Benton Williams as his wife, to receive him as your husband, to make a home where he will be loved and cared for as long as God grants you life? If so, answer, I do. The ceremony of marriage in which you come to be united is the first and oldest ceremony in the world, celebrated in the beginning in the presence of God Himself. Marriage is a gift of God, given to comfort the sorrows of life and to magnify its joys. Marriage is the clasping of hands, the blending of hearts, the union of two lives in one. Your marriage must stand not by the authority of the state, nor by the seal on your wedding certificate, but by the strength of your love and by the power of your faith in each other and in God. You can have this kind of home if you continue to recognize God as a source of romance and love and affection, for these are His gifts. Build your home on spiritual foundation. With God, you will have everything. Without Him, you will have nothing. The Word of God tells us that what love is and what it is like and what love does. Love is patient. Love is kind and is not jealous. Love does not brag, nor is it arrogant. Does not act unbecomingly. Does not seek its own. It does not provoke. Does not take into account wrong suffered. It does not rejoice in unrighteousness, but rejoices in the truth. Bears all things. Believes all things, hopes all things, endures all things. Love never fails. The New Testament also reveals that happiness comes from putting the other first rather than oneself. Be subject to one another in fear of Christ. Wives, be subject to your own husbands as to the Lord. Husbands, love your wives just as Christ loved the church and gave Himself for her. Let each individual among you also love his own wife, even as himself, and let the wife see to it that she respects her husband. Having this kind of love in your heart, you have chosen to exchange rings as a sign and seal of the vow you are making today. May I have the rings, please? Though small in size, these rings are very large and significant. Made of precious metal, they remind us that love is not cheap nor common. Indeed, love may cost us dearly. Made in a circle, their design tells us that love must never come to an end. You must keep it continuous. As you wear these rings, whether together or apart for a moment, may they be a constant reminder of those glad promises you are making together. Benton, will you take the ring? Will you take your ring and place it upon the third finger of Laura's left hand and repeat after me this promise, saying, "With this ring I seal my promise."
With this ring I seal my promise.
To be your faithful and loving husband.
Your faithful and loving husband.
As God is my witness.
As God is my witness.
Laura, will you take this ring and place it upon the third finger of Benton's left hand and repeat after me this promise, saying, "With this ring, I seal my promise to be your faithful and loving wife,
with your faithful and loving wife,
as God is my witness." Let's pray. Father in heaven, as we stand here in a most beautiful place, we just ask you to bless this couple. Be with them. Be with them for a lifetime of love and happiness. We just pray now that you continue to be with them through this ceremony, and we just thank you in Jesus' name. Amen. You have come before us. God. God has joined together, let man not separate. Now you can get fine. I present you, Mr. and Mrs. Williams.
Hey, Paul. Take your time.
Aloha, would you like
everyone
to say?
Everyone that's
going
to make it here.
And we love you.
Aloha!